I want to greet the pastor in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want to be grateful
for the permission and the confidence
he is always opening his pulpit to me.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In this kind of time where the pulpit should not be given anyhow to anybody. Praise the Lord.
It is a time of infection, spiritual infection. Spiritual poison is running out.
Praise the Lord.
I was walking and the voice spoke to me. Be aware of supernatural pictures. Stay far from supernatural pictures. Go and read the meaning. Praise the Lord. This is not more the time that the bride should be distracted. Anything that will not bring evidences of transformation, it may be true, but it may not be necessary for me.
Yes, sir.
If it doesn't bring effect in me that I can witness, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
Yes, we're at that time. Be careful. Praise God.
Amen.
Mark chapter 16, verse 17. Praise God. I'm reading. Mark 16:17. Signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Praise the Lord. Okay, you see that God is right. I see that the sister has put her eyeglass now. It's really a family disease. It will be over tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Yes.
I mean, no glaucoma. There was a time glaucoma was eating my left eye. And they told my mother that I cannot reach 32 years old. My left eye will close. And then they prescribed one expensive drug like this. I knew my mother cannot stand it. I was to buy that drug every week, one packet, 20,000. I said, Mommy, if you start this thing, where will you reach? You start buying this thing. They had the doctor till when, see, it will just be taking it until for maintenance. One day, I collected my glass. Eh? Eh? Are we together?
Yeah.
I said, if this glass is still in my hand, I will never believe. And I know if this glass break, my mother cannot buy another one because it's very expensive. She will tell me if you are broken, I cannot buy another one. I don't have money. So I allowed that glass to be broken. I said, by fire, by force, I will believe.
Amen.
I would have no choice to believe because I have no glass.
Yeah.
My mother cannot buy me, I cannot buy again. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Then there is no way. And the glass is no more there that I will use it to say the doctor say, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, that is faith. I wish that I would pray for you today. You put through that in me.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When is the Spirit that is telling you if you can just believe? When is God that is telling you? I do not remember you. I remember you. Will say, okay, maybe no. That after today you carry those old garments of glass. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We lay hand on those eyes to see well.
Amen.
And to those eyes pains to leave you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Brother John, do you believe? I know you are led by it depends. Do you believe?
I believe.
Yes. You do exactly as God said. Then we see if God can disgrace his name. He throw that old garment of glass, eyeglass affliction. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. Praise God.
Amen.
John chapter 14 verse 12. John 14:12. Ah, what a mystery. We're preaching on John tonight. And one John shall recover.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the work that I do shall he do also.
Amen.
And greater works than this shall he do. Because I go unto my Father. And whatever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Lord, we thank you. If our eyes can be opened, may we recognize our season.
Amen.
May we say like Jesus, Father, we know by the scriptures that the hour has come.
Amen.
Let great miracles, mighty wonders, mighty miracles. Mighty healing, gift, and deliverance be performed in the midst of your children tonight.
Amen.
Wherever the bride has come together to worship, we appreciate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. May we be seated. Praise the Lord. I want to wash because I have the reputation to be known, and I'm trying to destroy that reputation. Praise God. We will take, at least from the beginning of this program, we will try to open an aspect of the scripture that we title The Mystery of John 14:12. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Then we take our subject tonight. God's agent. Praise God.
Amen.
I don't know how to approach this. I wish it will be spoken to open-hearted people. To a spiritual grander church that will perceive the thought of the Spirit. Apostle Paul was talking to the Ephesians. He said, I'm supposed to give you meat, but still I can't. You are still at the level of milk. When you're supposed to be eating meat. When they went to the Hebrews, still referring of the Ephesian church, he said, you see, when you're supposed to be masters, I still have to teach you the first elements of faith. You know, Paul started mentioning legalism, the doctrine of the water baptism, the doctrine of the makeup, or the woman not wearing trouser, or the man not drinking. Paul was trying to tell to the Hebrews chapter 5 verse 14. He said the bride is supposed to have crossed the liver.
Amen.
The devil is the one that is preaching that kind of gospel again today. The bride has gone higher. If you read the scripture, either you want it or not, either it pleases you or not, the bride is supposed to have gone higher than that. She's supposed to be sitting in heavenly places, eating the mysteries of our kingdom.
Amen.
Because we really know by the prophet that this statement that the man that we have never really thought of it. This mystery truth revealed. This mystery truth divinely revealed that shall literally, remember the word literally. This mystery truth divinely revealed
has a purpose. Not to come and give us big heads.
My
English not good,
don't be here. But he mentioned the word shall literally turn the faith of the children unto the Father.
Amen.
What's the meaning of literally? That means physically.
Amen.
That means with physical evidence.
Amen.
That people will see and they will really see that really physically you have turned to the faith of the apostle. But something is happening, our mind has turned to the mind of the apostle. But not literally.
Amen.
We don't want to enter that matter because we don't want to be among the complainers. You know, Elijah was complaining one day and said, God, see the condition of the church. And God told him, Elijah, you have the panoramic vision. Who told you the church is sick? Elijah was talking of the world and God was looking at the church. He said, Elijah, you are complaining here, deceiving yourself. I have 7,000 men. Don't think because they are polluted here. Don't think it's everybody. When Satan is bringing complaint to you, using the condition of people you are seeing around you, tell the church like that. Tell him, yeah, that is a general vision. He said, I have 7,000 people that have never bowed. The question is, where were they? Can 7,000 people be in this Cameroon for revival and they will not be known? Elijah doesn't really know them. Because the revival of the mind is a silent revival.
Amen.
God was operating with them silently. And if you are among people that God is using, then allow Satan to make you begin to think that you are the only person.
Amen.
God is still keeping 7,000 people.
Amen.
You don't just know them. Maybe the heavy operating grids are higher than you. Just that God working silence.
Amen.
But if there have ever been a time that is a paradoxical time, at the moment the church is supposed to enjoy greater blessings, and the church is so oppressed, the church is so frustrated. If there have ever been a time, look at the believer eye to eye, see tears and sorrows. When Prophet Peter the man said, the vision. Is that right? Is that right? The victory day. Why did Jesus die in the cross? If there have ever been a generation that will take the perfection of that death in the cross, it's our generation.
Yeah.
The scripture says so. But see the paradox. Then the church has to wake up. We talk of the church, we talk of the individual.
Yes,
we don't tell the person that before I want to stand up, he look around him, his neighbor is standing up. We don't tell the person that if he wants to come early to church, he look around. If he never is coming early to church.
Amen.
God is saying, is that you begin to intercede for your church. He's looking around. He's always interceding with me. Since I'm interceding alone. Ah, since they don't want to intercede with me, let me drop it.
Amen.
Revival that we are going to see tonight has always come by one man.
Amen.
One man that we vex.
Amen.
One David that we say, hey.
Amen.
Am I dreaming? Is there a Philistine that is treating the children of God like, yo, make my eyes this? What an uncircumcised Philistine that is treating the children of the living God. The holy hand of David changed the whole story of Israel.
Amen.
Gideon has to be angry.
Amen.
The Bible says he came to a point that even the angel did not shake him. He said, you say you are the angel of what? Where's my business? That's why I told to you today that we should be aware of supernatural pictures. Gideon saw the angel face to face. I imagine the angel appearing here. All the social media will see the picture.
Amen.
But no one will ask himself, what has been the effect now in us?
Amen.
Gideon look at him and say, my brother, you don't impress me. Yes, you are angel and what?
Yes.
You are already an angel. Yes, your condition is good. What of me?
Yes.
He said, that man of God is there, one man of which man?
Amen.
God is with me, where are his miracles?
Amen.
You say God is with me, And these people are oppressing Israel a lot. Listen to what God wanted. And the Bible said they were altars of tradition. Christian dogma in the church. Established in those days. Gideon said too much. We are tired of these altars of tradition. Of legality. He kicked them out. And the Bible said he was the youngest among his brethren. You want to, you are feeling the pleasure of the man in your heart, but you say no because I'm not the head of the church. Who tell you God did by age? Yes. There is no CV in Christianity. You know what they call CV, no? Yes, I am 30 years in the faith. That doesn't mean. Amen. That's what they told to David. Oh, is that what I said, David? What we believe in, mister? You were not even born. You want to come and talk to God and see which you are fool? Professor, we should not assume. Yes. Do you think like that? Professor, we should play the tape first before we come to first dollar. Playing the tape without revelation. You don't bring any power to the tape. You are the tape. You have to be the tape. The Bible says David vexed. Gideon vexed. And his holy hunger attracted the presence of heaven. God said, hey, go to him. That is the man I was looking. The Bible says a man called Elisha had to vex. But look at this man. His story was peculiar. He has walked close with Elijah. Elijah, the mighty prophet, is the one that has ordained him. People have said, I've been ordained by Elijah. I'm hearing different type of CV. I was the driver of the prophet. I was a very good one. There is no CV with God.
Amen.
There was something peculiar with him and Elisha. He was holding the mantle. I'm hearing minister today. I have sat on the chair that prophet sat. I have entered his office. I have heard his gong. I have put myself on his coach. Church of the end time. I have went to his grave. I have pictures, shown the picture. Elisha was holding the mantle. But there was a challenge ahead. The Bible says he was standing this side of the river. The sons of the prophet was standing the other side. He was seeing vision, they were seeing vision. If they were not seeing vision, how did they know Elijah was going to heaven? She made told him, said, do you know your master is going to be? They saw it. They were having it.
Amen.
He looked at the mountain and said, what's the difference? I caught the coat. But he told me that if you see me go, hold the tape very strong. The tape was in the hand of Elisha. Not that the tape was wrong, but the attitude of holding the tape. He was having the tape, the mantle. But that mantle couldn't come alive until he had to vex. And say, where is the God of the tape? The Bible said, Elisha said, where is the difference? And the only one to know the difference is to go where the mountain has operated before. He said, this is the river Jordan. Then if it's the same coat, I will make this coat that snap. This river Jordan will be open. But the Bible says he shouted. He did not just put it in the water anyhow. He was angry in his spirit. The Bible says Elisha shouted. But where is the God of Elijah? That is where the son of the prophet had to bow before him.
Amen.
That we were coaching together before.
Amen.
We were seeing vision together.
Yes.
But now there is a difference.
Amen.
The thing that Elijah did with this matter, we are seeing them.
Yes, sir.
Praise God.
Amen.
But we are talking of a key. Praise God.
Amen.
Let us look at something here.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let us look at the divine agenda. The summon the angel of the Lord. Especially this English part of the message. And God has helped me to have the privilege to be both English and French.
Amen.
Legalism has carried us so far. Satan has brought one strange doctrine. People are suffering and afflicted. Yeah, we have nothing to see with the gift. If God can write anything among the bride, backbiting and blackmailing will kill it. But let's watch now. If, as I said, that the picture of this woman that rise up in purple color If he's the son of the believer, all the believers should be expecting a particular sign for them.
Praise God.
The angel of the Lord of 1948. Praise God. I want us to listen carefully. The angel of the Lord of 1948. The angel of God of 1948. I want to read from paragraph 1 and paragraph 2. Now see the agenda of the believer. This particular agenda, this video I've been sharing, and I've been seeing many believers who are not happy to share Pastor Chris. Is it Pastor Chris that will testify my prophet? Let the works that my prophet did testify of his message that I have received. It's not Pastor Chris that will come and testify my message for me. It is a shame. Yes, I know you will say, Brother William, that is too much. But we have our own sign that we should look up us to. Let's take it. Don't know one of you.
Pardon.
Don't know one go away from here now and say, Brother Bano say it is 10 years to the rapture. I do not know. Nobody does. Not even the angel of heaven knows. I don't know. But I know it is getting awful near. For the signs that he said will be taking place, he said he had been even at the door. And we are getting them right now. But look at the sign of the believer. We are getting those signs now. Physical sign. A woman coming to the US. But that should not be what you hold the attention of the bride. Let's check on it. Paragraph 2. I know the next thing to happen is the restoration of the gift to the church.
Amen.
That he knows. Prophet is given on the agenda of the rapture according now to the spiritual agenda. Then the one to be the bride, he says, see, there will be physical sign, but before that rapture, the next thing first, after we see the physical sign, the sign of the bride must happen. Amen. The restoration of the gifts.
Amen.
Some Pharisees spirit has entered the church. Amen. And I know why, I have understood why, and you must understand why. Satan hates gift because he knows genuine gift is to expose sin in the church.
Amen.
He knows that gift, he cannot do any nonsense in the church.
Amen.
Let me kill the gift fast. The next thing to happen, say prophet, before the rapture, that is one of the things we should be looking onward to, is the restoration of the gift to the church.
Amen.
Then we can just take now our scan. And we the silver and the mind, this is where we should be watching. Now, we're bringing our own to our register to place to base on something. The next is the restoration of the gift. Now, should we now, because of this, begin to go and pray that God send us gift? We know that we should not pray for the gift.
Amen.
They don't pray for gift.
Yes, sir.
Whosoever wants to pray for gift, you are doing a wrong, a very great mistake. Praise the Lord. Give them without calling.
Yes,
they are without repentance. If give them the manifest, you ask God why.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
And something begins to happen. The summon the angel of Satan, Satan eating. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Why I brought this topic, how it came to me, there was, I was in a mood. And I want to share that mood with you. Praise God.
Amen.
Satan's eating. Paragraph 7. Listen. Prophet said, and sometimes these little crude expressions bring us to something. It gets us to study and puts you to read the word. And that is what I want all my congregation to do. Prophet said, what must pull us to begin to study the scripture? What must stimulate us to begin to study the scripture? He said there are some expressions in the scripture that we should be looking on it twice.
Amen.
He that believeth in me, the work that I do, shall he do.
Amen.
Elisha, if you see me going, that you succeed to have a mantle, then the work that you have seen me do, you will do them. But something still happened. It happened that Elisha got the mantle and the work was not following him. He started thinking, could Elijah be wrong? No, God forbid, impossible. He's a vindicator, but he cannot say something just to say. If he said this pillar of fire will be wherever the message is preached, and that pillar of fire will manifest the work of God, that pillar of fire will produce the life of God, then we have to check not only the pillar of fire, but what it produced. And then I went to the scriptures. The work that I do, shall you do also, and greater. We know that this man walked upon water. He never said, I cannot walk upon water.
Amen.
What you never believe will never happen to you.
Amen.
Before something happens to you, you begin to believe it.
Amen.
No matter how impossible it looks like.
Amen.
We know that this man had a death that had been 4 days in the grave.
Amen.
Lord, but what? Why the bride is not performing it? Whatsoever you shall ask in my name, I shall answer that the Father shall be glorified in the Son.
Yes,
but we pray every morning, every night, every afternoon in Jesus Christ's name. Where are our prayer going? The prophet said this little crude expression must make us to study. That means the problem is somewhere else. The problem can never be the scripture. Then we must tell the scripture, begin to pray, Father, there is something. We always know that the scriptures have two faces.
Yes, sir.
That what prophet used the expression, this mystery truth divinely revealed. It cannot be carnally revealed.
Yes,
for he that read the letter shall die.
Amen.
But he that will read in the spirit shall receive life.
Amen.
What is then the key? What is the problem why this scripture cannot be manifested? Why we read it and we even say we believe it, but we don't see the scripture? There is something that we have not done to yet. Then we work it. We don't deceive ourselves with reasoning. If not, the result will never come. God will never visit a church that will not stand and say, Father, we recognize our stage. If the people that is called by my name shall gather and pray and come back from his own way, first, before I can answer.
Amen.
But this church that says she has nothing wrong.
Amen.
This church that is always perfect, she has the message.
Amen.
No, the message is not really proving the way it's supposed, but she deceiving herself. Which message am I reading? Is it when I finish to read the sermon Buddha, masturbation will attack me? Is it in the moment I'm just coming out from meditation that masturbation will attack me? Something's wrong now.
Amen.
Is that sermon book called masturbation anointing?
No.
No, I don't understand. I don't feel it from reading this sermon, but in the God I just see how lust will cover my eyes. So this sermon book has lost anointing.
No.
Something that is wrong somewhere.
Amen.
Why are we not manifesting Job 14:12? That this scripture that is linked to it, that is Mark 16:17. These are the signs that shall follow them that believe.
Amen.
I should not follow the sign, right? Say the prophet. But Simon, follow me.
Amen.
Them that follow the sign are wrong.
Amen.
Them that sense are not following us are wrong.
Amen.
The church will take the in between.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Simon, follow us. In another words, according to the way I'm reading this scripture, if I believe, I should just know, learn, work hard to believe, then I will be running, some will be following me.
Amen.
I'll be running, some will be pushing me.
Amen.
I'll be going on that bed, some will be pushing me.
Amen.
I'll say, sir, leave me now.
Amen.
Cannot leave me for 1 minute, sir. Wherever I go, some will pursue me. In my village, some will pursue me.
Amen.
In my school, some will pursue me.
Amen.
In my working place, some will pursue me.
Amen.
Yes, you must say amen to that.
Amen.
That is Mark 16:17. Wherever a believer must step his leg, the kingdom of Satan there must know.
Amen.
That a believer is there.
Amen.
Then, this is what happened to me. I started thinking, I started meditating on it. The work that I should do,
Then you are telling me that if I believe in you,
now see the scripture that we are going to study during 2 days, if God permits. You see three words. He that believes in me. God, do you mean why we don't believe? These are the signs that shall follow them that believe. And I started thinking, this keyword, the word that I do, shall he do, and greater. That before I do the greater one, I must first do the one he has done. Before I can be taken off, greater. Are we together?
Amen.
Let me do the one first.
Praise God.
Amen.
And I started meditating. My heart started groaning. My soul started traveling. And something shook my spirit. I will show you behind the scripture. This scripture answers only one question. How to manifest gift. And I'm going to prove it to you by the scripture.
How to operate gifts. How not to be praying and imagining gifts. The Bible says we should desire excellent gifts. Right? Possession. He said we should desire excellent gifts. That is not a sin to desire. But it's a sin to go and pray for gifts. But you can desire them. Then, how now? If I desire, there should be a key so that the gift must come. God always have. Praise the Lord.